After studying this module, you shall be able to know about stab wounds. That is the another type of sharp force injuries. What we discussed earlier was the incise wound and chop wounds. Now the stab wounds, the various types of stab wounds, the characteristic features of stab wounds, how to correlate between weapon and the stab wound, their medico-legal importance, as well as differentiate between suicidal, homicidal, and accidental stab wounds. To introduce the topic of sharp force injuries in this module, that is stab wound, I'll again begin with the same quote from Shakespeare, who wrote in Macbeth, quote, "Come thick night, that my keen knife sees not the wound it makes," unquote. Why I repeated this quote is because the same knife can produce incise wound as well as stab wound. It basically depends upon the manner of infliction that we will understand in this module about stab wounds. We have understood what are these incise wounds. A stab wound is a type of mechanical injury where depth is of the greatest dimension than the length and breadth, produced when the force is delivered along the long axis of a sharp pointed object such as knife, dagger, sword, chisel, screwdriver, all of these. Thus, a stab wound is caused by sharp pointed object either when the instrument is driven in the body or the body is pressed against or falls against the instruments. Now, there can be three possibilities depending upon the phenomena, that is the depth, the types of the stab wounds. The three types of stab wound are the punctured wound, the penetrating wound, and the perforating wound. So you can remember by three P's. A punctured wound typically punctures or terminates in flesh only. It may be due to the insertion of ice pick, needles, therapeutic injections. Needle puncture wounds due to drug addiction will present as old scars from the previous repeated punctures. In cases of death due to drug overdose or snake bite, the excised tissue along with the normal tissue around the puncture wound is to be sent for chemical analysis. The concealed puncture wounds may be missed in homicidal cases, especially when inflicted upon base of skull near nape of neck, thereby causing injury to the medulla. Then there may be an axilla or natural orifices like canthus of eye, ears, nostrils, vagina, rectum, etc. And these locations are chosen intentionally by the assailant to conceal or to hide the wound, and hence the terminology concealed puncture wound, which is usually found in cases of children. The second possibility or category of this stab wound is the penetrating wound. A penetrating stab wound typically penetrates or enters the body cavity like chest, abdomen, skull, orbit, and not exiting from the opposite end. Hence, a penetrating wound has got an entry, but there will be no exit wound. The wound, while describing, should be described in a sequential order as entrance wound, depth, direction of track, and location of the termination of the wound. And third possibility or category of a stab wound is the perforating wound. And as the name suggests itself, it perforates the body, and thus it has got both entry as well as exit wounds. The weapon enters through one surface of the body, say for example front of the trunk, and then exits out the opposite side, back of the trunk. Again, the wound should be described in a sequential manner. And in perforating wounds, the entry wound is larger than the exit wound, with the inverted edges. That means they are turned inside, inwards. The exit wounds is smaller than the entry with everted edges. That means the edges of the wound are turned outside. Sometimes underlying fat or part of the intestine may also protrude out from the wound. Then characteristic features of this stab wound. Important is the equivalence of dimension that we have to understand. When a knife is entering the body cavity, then the length of the wound corresponds to the width of the weapon. And the depth of the wound corresponds to the length of the blade of the weapon. And width of the wound corresponds to the thickness of that weapon, for example, knife. The length of the stab wound is normally less than the width of the weapon because of the fact that the severed or the cut elastic fibers in the skin, they tend to recoil and the actual length of the wound diminishes. To predict the corrected width of the weapon, the edges of the wound should be brought together and measured at the time of examination. However, deliberate rocking of the blade during withdrawal from the body, this may tend to elongate the length of the stab wound than the breadth. Then if you see the margins of the wound, they will be either clean cut when the weapon has sharp edges, for example knife, or it may be contused also if the weapon has got a round edges like a cricket stump or ice pick or a screwdriver. If these are used, the idea is the sharp and pointed weapon. Any pointed object can produce stab wounds like these. The entry wound may also have the patterned abrasion of the hilt surrounding the injury. And this hilt is produced when the weapon having a hilt is thrusted with force along the whole length of the weapon. The depth of the wound is the greatest dimension in stab wounds, and assessing the depth of the injury is very important from the medico-legal point of view. But in a living patient, the wound should never be probed to assess its depth because it may produce false tracks or may dislodge even clot, leading to fatal hemorrhage or may cause further injuries or alter the appearance of the injury. So whenever depth is to be measured, it has to be done in the operation theater when the wound is being repaired. The depth of the wound is usually equal to or less than the length of the blade. But on yielding surfaces like the anterior abdominal wall, the depth of the wound may be greater because the force of the thrust may press the tissues underneath. In young persons, the chest is mobile and thus may be compressed during stabbing. However, expansion and contraction of the chest while breathing has to be considered. The viscera of the dead body are not in the same position as the living human being. So, what happens during the fright, fight or flight? The victim may be moving or changing his position. So, during this process, when the abdomen is tensed, then the distance between the abdominal wall and the spine is reduced. And when the same body is on the autopsy table, the abdomen is relaxed and this distance increases. Similar sequence of events happens with other visceral organs as well. So thus in a stab wound, the postmortem depth of the wound is greater than the antemortem wound. If the stab injury is at the back of chest, then the depth of the wound will be less because the lungs will collapse posteriorly. Thus, if we see the depth of the stab wounds, it depends upon many factors. Like, one is the condition of the knife. The sharpness of the tip of knife is of extreme importance rather than its cutting edge, as a sharp pointed tip will perforate with more ease. A blunt pointed instrument will take more effort to penetrate. Second parameter is the resistance offered by the tissues or organs. the skin and muscle is not much resistant to knife penetration, whereas the uncalcified cartilage, this usually gets penetrated easily by sharp knife and more force is required. The clothings, they also play important role. The multiple layers of clothings like thick leather jacket, coats, they will require greater force for stab injury if the person has worn that. Greater the speed of the thrusting knife, deeper is the penetration power. So it is also the speed of the weapon with which it is inserted into the body. That also affects the appearance of the wound or the depth of the wound. When the knife strikes at a right angle over a stretched skin, then the depth is greater in comparison if it is inserted in some other angle other than the right angle. So, over the autopsy table while conducting the postmortem examination, the depth is measured by inserting a pliable tube gently into the track, and if it goes easily, the true track will be revealed. Then tissue dissection is carried out parallel to and away from the wound to reveal the track. Or we can use the radio-opaque material or dyes. They can be injected into stab wounds to demonstrate the wound of the track by X-rays also. Then shape of the wound. The shape and size of the stab wound depends upon the type of implement, its cutting surface, sharpness, width and shape of the weapon. All these factors affect the shape of the wound. Also, on the body region being stabbed, the depth of insertion, the angle of withdrawal, the direction of thrust, the movement of the blade, cleavage direction, movement of the person stabbed, as well as the condition of the tension and relaxation of the skin. All these factors affect. The cleavage lines of Langer, they are the lines within the skin along which the dense framework of intimately intermingled dermal collagen and elastic fibers are arranged. So they are arranged in a parallel rows and are same in all persons. In the extremities, they run longitudinally, and in the neck, they run circumferentially. The stab wounds which run across the lines, they gape more, and a stab wound which lies parallel to it produces an oval cut. The shape of the weapon influences the shape of the stab wound immensely, and this helps in identifying the weapon of offense. We can further elaborate it here as, if a single edged weapon is used, then it will produce a wedge shaped or triangular shaped wound. The angle caused by the sharp edge is acute, and the one caused by the blunt edge is rounded or squared off, and this forms the base of the wedge shape. Sometimes the blunt edge produces a split such that the wound appears like the tail of a fish, and this is called as fish tailing of the wound. So this will be produced in case of single edged weapon. If the weapon is double edged, that means both edges of the weapon are sharp, then it will produce elliptical shape or spindle shaped injury. Sometimes a single edged weapon may produce spindle shaped injury when some part of the knife or some length of the knife near its tip may be double edged and the skin was too elastic. Usually the angle corresponds to the blunt edge, and this reflects the shape of initial few centimeters. If the weapon is thrusted with considerable force, then the skin will let in without much change of the shape. If the weapon penetrates at an oblique angle, the blunt edge doesn't impart any shape at all as it does not contract. Then a single or double edged weapon may produce a wound with both ends blunt. If the weapon is thrusted up to the level of ricasso, that is the sharp and unsharpened section of the blade in between the cutting blade and the guard, that is called as ricasso. In such confusing cases, the serosal planes and the underlying structures which are cut should be examined properly to opine regarding the weapon involved. A rounded object with a pointed tip, for example a spear or ice pick, this produces a circular one. Then a round object with blunt tip, as in cricket stump, ballpoint pen, pointed stick, these all produce a circular wound with contused, inverted and ragged margins. The more blunt the tip, the coarser or stellate shape the injury will be. A pointed square weapon like a screwdriver, this produces a cross-shaped injury, each of the four edges producing its own cut. Then in a thick and relatively blunt weapon like bayonet, the penetrating wound may be associated with laceration. A stabbing followed by rocking, twisting or movement of the victim may change the initial shape of the wound into a L or a V shape, where one limb will correspond to the weapon and the other limb is an extension of it. If a knife has serrated edge, they produce the ragged margins. Then the next characteristic feature of the wound is the direction of the wound. If the weapon is penetrated at an angle, the margins are beveled on one side and undermined on other side. If the weapon is withdrawn and thrusted again, two or more punctures may be seen in soft parts. In solid organs, the track made by the weapon is seen in better manner. The principal direction of the wound should be noted first. In a penetrating wound, the entrance wound should be described first, followed by the depth, direction of the wound and specific termination. And while describing a perforating wound, the description should be complete till the exit wound. So start from the entry and finish at the exit wound. Then the complications in case of stab wounds. The patient may die of hemorrhagic shock, as internal hemorrhage may be marked due to involvement of vital organs, though there may not be any marked external hemorrhage. So externally there may not be visible hemorrhage, but internally there will be massive hemorrhage. Then the air embolism may occur due to involvement of the neck vessels, and this air may be sucked into the vessels due to the negative pressure. The infection may set in due to lodgement of foreign body. Asphyxia due to inhalation of blood might occur. The pneumothorax might occur. Coming on to the medico-legal importance of the stab wounds. The shape of the wound indicates the class and type of the weapon involved. So the doctor should also examine the weapon of offense if recovered, and should record its length, weight and thickness, whether single-edged or double-edged, the degree of taper from the hilt to tip, the nature of the back edge of the single-edged, whether serrated or clean or squared off, the shape of the hilt guard, whether any grooving or serration or forking of the blade is there, because this information helps in corroborating the weapon with the injury found over the body. The depth of the wound indicates the force of penetration. The age of the injury can be determined by various changes, just like the incised wound. The direction and dimensions of the wound indicates the relative position of the assailant. The manner of the injury is determined from the position, direction and number of wounds. Then is the harakiri, that is the Japanese term. In Japanese, it is called as seppuku, also synonym, that is cutting the belly. And this is unusual form of suicidal stab wound by a short sword. In this, the victim inflicts a single large wound of the abdomen with a short sword while in a sitting position, or falls forward upon a ceremonial sword and pulls out the intestines. This is called as harakiri. The sudden evisceration of the internal organs, this causes a sudden decrease in intra-abdominal pressure and cardiac return. This produces sudden cardiac collapse and death. The overkill homicide. The assailant continues the stabbing beyond the victim's death. This happens in hate crimes usually. The postmortem stab wounds will not show any bruising and are often yellow or tanned due to absence of tissue perfusion and are sharply defined. accidental stab wounds are rare but may be seen on accidental fall from height, on projecting objects, or in animal attacks by the horn of the bull. Then this table differentiate between suicidal, homicidal, accidental stab wounds. We can differentiate all these depending upon the features like the cause, the position, the grouping, the direction, the severity, the presence of defense wound, the secondary injuries, the weapon, the clothes, by thoroughly examining the scene of crime as well as the motive. All these, because as the name suggests, in cause, suicidal wound, it will be self-inflicted, homicidal by other, accidental falling on the sharp object. Position, accessible areas in suicidal wounds, generally on vital parts and can be anywhere in case of homicidal wounds, accidental can be anywhere. If it is in the grouping of the wound, it will be uniform in parallel lines with hesitational cuts in case of suicidal, whereas there will be no definite grouping in case of a homicidal, and accidental also most of the time single large wound. The direction, left to right in right-handed person and vice versa, whereas in homicidal it can be of any direction. Accidental, it is usually straight inside. We see the severity of the wound. The suicidal, mostly superficial stab wounds, very deep and severe in case of homicide, and accidental, it is variable. The defense wounds will be absent in case of suicidal and accidental, whereas it will be present in case of homicidal wounds. The secondary injuries will be present in case of homicidal wounds, where those will be absent in case of suicidal wounds. The weapon may be found by the side of the body in case of suicidal wounds, whereas it will not be present by the side in case of homicidal wounds. Accidental, it will be present. The clothes are not damaged in case of suicidal wounds, whereas these will be damaged in both homicidal as well as accidental wounds. The scene of crime, if we examine, is usually in a closed, isolated room with no disturbance or of surrounding household goods that will indicate suicide, whereas it will be disturbed and disorganized surroundings with signs of a struggle in case of homicide. Motive will be present in case of suicide, like domestic violence, disappointment, etc. The motive will be different in homicide, the robbery, revenge, sexual offense, etc. Whereas there will be no motive in case of accidental injuries, accidental stab wounds. To summarize the topic of a stab wound is a type of mechanical injury produced by sharp pointed object where depth is of greatest dimension than the length and breadth produced, when the force is delivered along the long axis of a sharp pointed object like knife, dagger, sword, chisel, screwdriver, anything. When a knife is entering the body cavity, then the length of the wound corresponds to the width of the weapon. The depth of the wound corresponds to the length of the blade of the weapon, and width of the wound corresponds to the thickness of the blade of the weapon. There are three types of stab wounds denoted by 3 P's: punctured, penetrating, and perforating. The direction and dimensions of the wound indicates the relative position of the assailant. The depth of the wound is the greatest dimension and is usually equal to or less than the length of the blade. The harakiri is an unusual form of suicidal stab wound of abdomen using a short sword. The sword which is having a short length, short blade. The manner of death can be commented by thorough and meticulous examination of the wound, whether it's a suicidal, homicidal, or accidental.